Okay, Trương Anh Tuấn, call me Tuấn, from Vietnam. I'm the Vice President of VFOSA. It stands for Vietnam Free and Open Source Software Association. About 5 years ago, we tried to form up from a lot of open source community to an association called VFOSA. Today, I would like to introduce about our association and then something about the FOSS ecosystem in Vietnam. And the last one is a case study, a brand new project, open source project, just open for public sector. Who we are? Well, we are a kind of local NGO. We act in non-profit and try to promote open source and open things, everything, every open things in Vietnam. We founded in 2012, and before that, we are a lot of small communities, for example, Linux user groups, or some other kinds of community. We try to form up into an association for better working with government, with university, with enterprises, and so on. Nowadays we have about 50 members. It's increased week to week, month to month. We try to enlarge our association. We have some kind of universities, institutes, government agencies, enterprises, and hundreds of individual members. In VFOSA, we try to represent for the Vietnam open source communities to work with the government agencies. We try to consult them to do the best thing for the IT system, for the e-government. We try to propose policy changes for them to have better policies for IT development. We working with the whole committees. Nowadays, the open source committee members in Vietnam about hundreds thousands people. They divided to a lot of small community. We try to connect them together to promote open things, everything. Like open source, open hardware, open data, open educational resources, and a lot of other open things. We try to work with universities, institutes, and other educational organizations, try to do capacity building to have more human resources for open source. That's the VFOSA, our association. Next, I would like to introduce a little about the open source ecosystem in Vietnam. In Vietnam, we have most of organizations in Vietnam now try to involve into the open source community, including the government agencies. We have the main big related IT related ministry, like the Ministry of Information and Communication. They have a lot of policy to promote and encourage the open source uses in Vietnamese government agencies. we have Ministry of Science and Technology who support a lot to promote, to do localization, to do buildings, open source solutions, and so on. We have a lot of other government agencies currently use open source every sector. In universities, we are working with a lot of universities in Vietnam, both IT or non-IT universities. We work with state universities, but especially we prefer to work with private universities because their policy, their needs is more close to the open source. They can easily to decide. They can easily decide to adopt to open source. In Vietnam, we work with a lot of universities along the Vietnam from the north to the south. You know, Vietnam is a long country. Hanoi, Da Nang, Ho Chi Minh City, Cần Thơ, and a lot of big cities. Some institutes we just government just established the center called National Center for Research and Development Open Technology. They just established, but they will help much to the community to do more open source research and development. I believe that. In FOSS ecosystem in Vietnam, we also have enterprises. As I mentioned before, we have about 50 members in FIFOSA. Over half of them are companies, are enterprises, and they may be open source user, open source integrator, or hire open source contributor. They run some open source projects, open source committee, a lot of levels. We have also a lot of individuals like a traditional Linux user group, Fedora or Ubuntu community in Vietnam, or they may be some localization team for Ubuntu, for LibreOffice, Mozilla, or something. We have a committee in DevOps, system engineer, or in programming like Python, Java, PHP, or something. A lot of type of committees and a lot of individuals member try to involve into the open source committees. We also try to promote some other related open things like open technologies, engineering, open data. Earlier of this month, March, we organized the first open data event in Hanoi, the Vietnam capital. It's called Open Data International Day. And now I would like to bring to you a case study. We just established a new project. It's called OpenCPS, stands for Core Public Services. In government agencies, the Vietnamese government try to build e-government. In the past, they bought a lot of proprietary solutions from my shop, from IBM or some other vendors. Even in Vietnam, the company, the enterprises in Vietnam, they provide service, provide solutions to the government by proprietary solutions, not much open source. Some other try to provide open source, but they pick open source, maybe close it, give to the government, something else. But it's in the past. Now, a lot of enterprises in Vietnam, they see the chances to provide services, open source services to government. That's why we come up with about four companies. We try to form up to the projects for public services. That's open source project called OpenCPS. From the four companies, we try to apply the open source development model from the beginning, from the README file. What project is or something, we try to put them a license. Here is AGPL, and try to put everything on GitHub on in AGPL license. We try to have transparent roadmap and plan to encourage people, more people, to join into our project. We try to do the methodology like document first and then code following. So from the beginning, a lot of documents put on the GitHub, put on the wiki, a lot of guidelines, roadmap, plans, and everything. We try to build documentation first and then encourage people to join into our project. You can see our project just opened about a month, but everything open on GitHub. And we have public communication channels on mailing list, IRC, and we have regular meetings on IRC with Meetboard to log the meeting minutes. We have a website. If you can see on the internet, everything. So we try to do documentation first, as I mentioned before. Everything, business analysis like software requirement, specification, and system architect, detailed design, test case, test plan, installation guides, packaging, or a lot of documentations. We wrote guidelines for the contributor to join into our project, development process, coding conventions, Git flow guidelines, job description for each role in joining to the project, public communication, of course, and a lot of things we try to do documentation first. We also public the whole system architecture, just very simple, but we will try to make it more detailed later and later. Open from the beginning. In our architecture, the system architecture, we try to build a back end and have room for everyone to build front end to connect that back end. Including Java, PHP, .NET, mobile, or everything. They can make any front end to connect to our open source backend with the API, predefined API. That is a Git flow we apply it to the project. We try to open to public the roadmap for this year, and we try to make the roadmap for next several years. And after a month, we trying to do the right things. I think they are the right things. And after a month, from four company, we encourage another some other company. Now we have dozens contributors from over 10 companies in Vietnam, because the core public service, the first versions of it, we want to apply to Vietnamese government, so maybe it's suitable for Vietnamese to come first. But in the future, maybe we want to enlarge this to the other country, ASEAN or all over. I would like to put something about another long time project, open source project in Vietnam. It's called Nook Viet CMS. Why I would like to mention to this project, because this is one of the first committee want to join into OpenCPS to build a front end. It's a CMS built on PHP a long time, about 10 years in Vietnam, open source 10 years. And they want to build a front end to connect into OpenCPS backend. A lot of interesting things. We try to connect the community together. So that's all. I want to introduce something about Vietnam. Thank you. Have you got any question? Okay.
For open. For OpenCPS, you choose HGPL as the copyright to it. Why HGPL?
Yeah. As I try to introduce, I want to introduce a bit about myself. I participate in open source community about 15 years, and I dig into the licensing a lot. Firstly, OpenCPS, I would like to build a project which open every time, the whole life. When I use the license like this, I want the next derivation on the next fork, they use the same license. So we can choose GPL, but we decided to use AGPL because one more statement, they reinforce if the service provider try to run OpenCPS on their cloud with some change or without change anything, but they must open the source for the user. That's why, because in Vietnam nowadays the member companies in OpenCPS not have big four companies like Viettel, VNPT or something. We want to protect OpenCPS project. If Viettel or something want to use OpenCPS to run on our cloud to provide services to government, they must open the source code as under AGPL license. That's the reason. Okay. Any more questions?
How long did the process of combining all these various open source groups take to have your to organize your first meeting of VFOSA.
Yeah. Okay. About VFOSA, I would like to introduce Mr. Quang, our president. Mr. Quang, can you stand up? Yeah. We are in a separate communities for a long time. As I mentioned, I joined into the open source projects for over 15 years, including a lot of big committee in all over the world, like Fedora. Fedora committee know me a lot. So in Vietnam, we are in separated committees. Then we try to, one day we sit down together and decided we must have a bigger group, an official group to do something, do some better thing, official things. So as a long time participating in open source community like me, like Mr. Quang and some other, we just decided, and then we try to connect to the government agencies and as an association, as an organization, like Vietnam Association for Information Processing. So we try to convince them to accept us to be the new member in the community, in society. That's all. It's easy.
I was a bit curious because I noticed you listed in your member organizations or parts of or who is part of VFOSA, some ministries and private I guess if you have smaller groups from private universities, it's easier to convince them to join and to take part in your organization.
Yeah.
But talking to government can be a nightmare for. So I'm wondering how long, whether you face any roadblocks in that process or.
Yeah.
Anything that
The time before VFOSA established, we already have some connection with government agencies, not just from VFOSA established before that. So when we form up to an official association, it's much easier for us to work with the government agencies. Much easier. We work with them before, but after that, it's much easier. We have an official voice for the open source community to talk with government agencies. After the VFOSA established, a lot of other policies to promote open source and other IT sectors. Okay. It's not a nightmare.
Just one question.
Yeah. Okay.
While talking about Vietnam, one part I think you are mentioning that you are working on the policy segment. In the policy segment, in one part there are laws which prevents freedom of expression. For example, copy pasting from a social media can even get you jail. That kind of laws are there. So usually in many countries, I found false people are the same people campaigning for freedom of expression, but that resulting in love and hate relationship with government. So how you find, because while working with government, if you are campaigning against them in some other aspects, sometimes it will not work. So how you are finding the balance?
Yes. it's difficult. It's not easy. Yeah, first of all, in the past, the open source situation is really bad. And following the movement from all over the world, and inside Vietnam, we have an official organization. So we try to put together inside community and outside community to push our government. It's not easy. It's a long story.
I think we would do well to maybe have another talk, 2-hour session for the whole series of long stories that we have.
Yeah.
But in the absence of other questions, let's thank the speaker again.
Okay. Thank you.